Hi you all. So this week, for the very first time, I'm not here for any poetry recitation. Rather, I'd be reviewing three books which I've read in past Diwali and Dashera holidays. I'll not review this book. I'd rather persuade you to read them because they were like my best reading experience throughout. If you like this video and this helped you in some or the other way, do like the video and subscribe to my channel. So without further ado, let's start with the first book, which is The Kite Runner by Khalid Hosseini. Now just Google out any of the must-read articles out there and you won't find even a single article without mentioning this book in it. This book has Afghan background, Taliban, murder, suicide attempts, bullying, rape, and well, kite flying, of course. I'll not give away any spoilers because I want you all to have the first-hand reading experience of it. But to talk about the plot of this story, I just say that this book is about two young boys of Afghanistan who are brother-like friends but are of totally different socio and economic background. And what life does to the weaker protagonist is really heartbreaking. Reading this book was such a nice experience for me that my obvious another pickup was a book by same author Khalid Hosseini, which is A Thousand Splendid Sun. And well, oh my god, if you would ask me if this book is as good as Kite Runner, well, I'd say no, this is even better. In 7th or 8th page, the female protagonist, who is 5-year-old Maryam, is first introduced to the word harami. Well, one of my seniors said me not to read this book because this might break my heart. And seriously, in the middle of the book, I was asking myself, why? Why am I reading this? Because it is really, really strong to take in. You squirm, you cry out in outrage, you scream. But Hosseini isn't yet finished. To talk about the plot, this book is about Afghani women who are generation apart, who fight from domestic violence, Taliban, societal oppression, all together through it and pave their way out. Though Maryam gets killed by the end. I'll read out one paragraph of this book for you, which will be kind of my build-up for my another book. And so if you read I Am Malala, it is said the Taliban first came as harbingers of development. We're harbingers of development. Isn't that a quite hard phrase right now in our country? So the paragraph goes around like this. It is a radio announcement by Taliban which says, our vatan, known as Islamic Emirates of Afghanistan. These are the laws that will enforce and you will obey. Singing is forbidden, dancing is forbidden, playing card, playing chess, gambling and kite flying is forbidden. Writing book, watching film and painting pictures are forbidden. If you keep parakeets, you will be beaten, your birds will be killed. Attention women, you will stay inside your home at all times. It is not proper for women to wander aimlessly about the streets. If you go outside, you must be accompanied by a mahram, a male relative. If you are caught alone on the streets, you will be beaten and sent home. You will not, under any circumstances, show your face. You will cover it with burqa when outside. If you do not, you will be severely beaten. Cosmetics are forbidden, jewelry is forbidden, you will not wear charming clothes. You will not speak until spoken to. You will not make eye contact with men. You will not laugh in public. If you do, you will be beaten. You will not paint your nails. If you do, you will lose a finger. Girls are forbidden for attending schools. All schools of the girls will be immediately closed. Women are forbidden from working. If you found guilty of adultery, you will be stoned to death. Listen, listen well, obey, Allahu Akbar. Well, after reading this paragraph, I felt so, so lucky to be born in India with total freedom of expression, no religion-based discrimination. And I guess you will be grateful too. But wait, hold on a second. Is that really true or just a delusion? Which brings me to my next book, Gujrat Files by Rana Ayyub. Talking about this book, as the name suggests, Gujarat Files. This is about all the well-known facts which are not legally proven yet. The only difference is This book contains all these facts spoken by higher official, which is on record. To speak about this book, it is a transcript of various sting operations done by Tehelka Magazine and Rana Ayyub through a time period of 6 months. Though being an Amazon bestseller, you will not find this book in any of the bookstores or any ready market outside because people are hesitant. Even my father suggested me not to review this book, and I had a hard time explaining them that I don't even have that great amount of audience to my channel. But this is the reality. This is the kind of democracy we are living in today. Rajan Priyadarshan, DG of Anti-Terrorism Squad 2007 Gujarat, is quoted as saying, Amit Shah never believed in human rights. He said he does not believe in Human Rights Commission, and the court bailed him too. Well, they are the harbingers of development in our society right now, isn't it? Supporting a party is a different thing, but I'd suggest that this book should be read by both the sides of the house, because staying aloof of the grave situation is not a solution. So out of these three, the book which I would suggest you to read quite urgently is this Gujarat Files, because I think reading this book is quite urgent. You should read it before this book gets banned, Rana Ayyub gets killed, or this video gets deleted. Or you should read it before it gets too late, because 2019 elections are not that far. So if my video helped you in any way and you liked this video, if you were with me all through the video, do subscribe to my channel. The link to this book is given in the description box below. And I'll take care of your trust with full responsibility. Bye-bye.
My only concern was when I went to a journalism college about 12 years ago, nobody told me that stories can be killed, and when you go approach a story and when you do a report on a story, the editor has every right to kill a story, but I learned it the hard way. The Home Secretary, Ashok Narayan, telling me and speaking to me about, in as many words, the complicity of Narendra Modi and Amit Shah. I have G.C. Raigar, who is one of the intelligence guys, G.L. Singhal, who is the guy who shot Ishrat Jahan, who says, when I shot Ishrat Jahan, I had no idea she was a terrorist. I have Rajan Priyadarshi, who was the ex-ATS chief, who tells me that one of the days Mr. Amit Shah called me to his bungalow and said, Tumhare jo custody mein teen log hai, unko udana hai. So Mr. Rajan Priyadarshi tells him ki sir ye hum nahi kar sakte hain because ye thoda galat hai. So thoda galat hai. Then he said, are tum darte kyu ho? Dekho humne Ishrat ko do din apne farm mein rakha tha.
Ek dari hui patrakarita, ek dara hua loktantra.